MC Toon has put out a $10,000 challenge. Calculate, using Flat Earth Geometric, the position of an observer with three elevation angles to three given stars. There are some more elaborate conditions, but this is where it comes down to. Up till now, there has no flarefer been able to submit a solution to this challenge. There are many flarefers that have reacted to the challenge with all kinds of diversions, excuses and so-called proof that MC Toon basically is a flarefer himself. One of the most prolific flarefers who has reacted is Nathan Oakley, who has stated, as he claims around 50 times by now, that you cannot measure an elevation angle on a curved surface, a curved baseline, a curved adjacent, in short, you need a flat plane for that, so the Earth must be flat for celestial navigation with a sextant to work at all. He is convinced that he is right, or he is playing the part of someone who is convinced that he is right. Let's assume that he is right. How has MC Toon got his three elevation angles? There are four possibilities. 1. He has pulled three random elevation angles out of his backside. 2. He picked a position and reverse engineered the three matching elevation angles. And 3. He deliberately has chosen three elevation angles that lead to three circles of equal latitude that don't cross, so there is no solution to the problem. Even if the three elevation angles cannot give a position, you should be able to demonstrate that. All of these three possibilities are not related to the shape of the Earth. They are not measured elevation angles at all. They are just a bunch of random numbers. There should be no problem for a flurfer to solve this problem using their infamous flat Earth geometry. But there is a fourth possibility. MC Toon has measured the elevation angles himself. According to Nathan Oakley, he couldn't have measured these elevation angles on a globe Earth, so he must have measured them on a flat Earth. Although MC Toon himself thinks that he measured them on a globe Earth, Nathan Oakley is convinced that he must have measured them on a flat Earth. But then the question is, if the elevation measurements could only have been performed on a flat Earth, why does Nathan Oakley use the argument that the challenge is debunked, because the elevation angles could only have been measured on a flat Earth? It's always nice to see a flurfer shoot himself in the foot. There are four possible ways MC Toon could have gotten hold of his elevation angles. Three of them are not related to the shape of the Earth, and one of them is, in the eyes of Nathan Oakley, only possible if MC Toon stood on a flat Earth. So raking in an easy $10,000 should be a piece of cake for him or any other flurfer who is an expert in flat Earth geometry. They always come up with all kinds of excuses, always diverting the discussion to what the Earth is not, instead of what the Earth is. And most of the time, their excuses are incoherent, inconsistent, and sometimes even contradicting excuses used before on another topic. The Flat Earth Emperor has no clothes on, and is proud of it.